A 3:30 kick, the Florida Heat bearing down, and a lopsided scoreboard. You line up across from your opponent, what do you see? Is it fear, fatigue, a broken will? We all know what they see. A brotherhood, one built on faith, friendship, and most of all, family.
Great atmosphere. It's been electric every time we've walked into that stadium. Our players appreciate what our fans are buying into and the energy that they create. And we're really thankful that this city is taking ownership of this team and liking the product that they see, and hope we continue to see that as we go through the season.
I mean, you look at the campus, you look at the way the coaches have been recruiting. I mean, there's not a better place to be in Florida. I know I can
settle the score. As today, the 13th ranked UCF Knights look to stretch the nation's longest win streak to 17. A feel like temperature of 100 degrees as we get set for game number 4 of the 2018 college football season.
Tight ends, wide receivers, running backs, 20 minutes.
Hey, brothers on three, brothers on three. One, two, three.
Brothers.
Play harder than they do. Play with everything you got, every snap. Play for one another, all right?
They want what we got. They want what we work so hard for. From the sideline to the field. Give it everything that you got. Yeah. We're going to be victorious today, all right? One team.
Family. Over. Everything. Hey. Speed is the name of the game at UCF, and like they have many times this season, the Knights came out hot.
Adrian Killens, 64 yards. He's going to run. Can he get to the two? He'll get to the one. Touchdown. McKenzie Milton weaving through the defenders into the end zone. He back to throw. He'll look. He'll punt. He'll throw to the corner. Gabriel Davis, is he there? Got it. Touchdown. McKenzie Milton to Gabriel Davis. Touchdown, 24 yards and a 13-0 lead.
McKenzie Milton had himself another record-setting day. It was also the second time in his career he would win the Walter Camp Player of the Week.
Looks, throws to the end zone. Otis Anderson got a touchdown. Otis Anderson.
Special teams was the first to put points on the board for the Panthers with an 86-yard punt return late in the first quarter. How would the Knights respond to adversity? I think we all know.
20-yard line, 15-yard line, 10 to the 5.
A lot of times me getting a rushing touchdown is because of a running back, you know, springing a block on a Mike back, or like whatever comes my way is because of what the guys up front are doing and what the running backs are doing.
Boasting two picks and a forced fumble already in the early season, Richie Grant once again saw himself in the right place at the right time.
We all ball hungry, so anybody get a turnover, you know, you're going to get your head slapped a couple times. You know, might get in concussion protocol, get slapped too much. I mean, we love it, man, because we know that's what we can do.
Off in McKenzie, going to throw the end zone. It is caught. Touchdown, Michael Quilibiani. Did he get a foot down? Yes. And the first half will end. 31-7, Knights on top. We'll check in with Jerry O'Neill. We wanted 7 to end the half there, but we'll take the 3 in a 24-point lead.
Yeah, the way things were playing out, 31-7 at the half, that'll open some eyes around the country against Pitt today.
Playing with McKenzie is like playing backyard football. He's a phenomenal quarterback, phenomenal leader, phenomenal person. So playing ball with him is amazing.
He throws. Killen's got a 50. To the house he goes. Nobody's getting him. Killen's gone. Boom.
Well, the Knights' offense was busy pushing the chains down the field with 31 first downs on the day. The defense spent their afternoon in Panther fashion.
They play football just like we do. They put on their pads just like we do. And beating Pitt was just another game that we had on our schedule. And we're just going to get better from here.
You know, us just keep winning games will speak for itself. And Whether it's an ACC, SEC, American Conference opponent, you know, we approach it the same.
Love and appreciate the way you are continuing to grow. You're continuing to grow every single day, all right? Nothing's bigger than the team. Nothing is bigger than the team. Dial into that, all right? And it's an unstoppable force. Everybody got me?
Yes, sir.
That's 17 straight victories for the Knights. And no sweeter way to celebrate than with the ones you love. It's back to conference play next week for Coach Heupel and his Knights as they play host to the Mustangs of SMU.